This class is going to discuss how to release retainage on a subcontract. So first, I'm going to show you the subcontract we're going to be working with. So Acme Door and Glass Distributors. There's a subcontract here. You scroll down for $1,000. You can see the $50 retained or 5%. Okay, so we want to make sure this has been invoiced. So we actually have a liability to work with out there. And I'm going to go over here to the subcontract invoice that we've already created. And if we scroll down to the bottom, you can see the $50 in retainage. Okay, so now let's say we've paid them already $950 and we want to pay the remaining $50 to them. So we're going to navigate up here to accounts payable, retainage, and the retainage screen is going to come up here. Okay. So we're going to come up here and we're going to add a batch. And let's just call it something simple, Acme Retainage. Now you can do multiple retainages for multiple subcontractors, but we're just doing this one. So we're going to hit save and continue, create a batch name here. And the button you want to hit next is to add the subcontracts is the add button here, okay? So it's going to pull up what's available to be released for retainage. Okay, so we're going to click this one here. We're working with the Burns Restaurant one. We're going to hit add selected. Hit done, and we're done with the screen. And you can see the item that I've selected here. Now I want to release 100% of this, so I'm going to hit the retainage release button. I'm going to type in 100. And now you can see my amount to release went from 0 to 50. Okay, so now we're going to come up here and hit release retainage. And now this bill is ready to be paid in the pay bill screen on the accounts payable menu.